During this section, we're going to see how easy it is to gather information about people and how some free tools that has been created for a good reason can be manipulated to gather those information. Let me give you a small example. What is the most important piece of information you need to get if you plan to compromise someone? Let's talk on personal basis. I'm not talking about now company basis. If I need to compromise someone sitting on his computer remotely, how can I do that? What is the most important piece of information? Is IP. If I was able to get his public IP, you know, this is a very important information, and then I can use this IP to compromise his system. Now, is it easy to get someone IP remotely? I mean, he's sitting somewhere in some country and I need to get his IP. Is it easy? If he send me an email, it's easy. I can open the email and then check the header. But what if he didn't send me an email? Okay. Some free tools can be used to gather such information. And I'm going to start with this specific tool for mail tracing. You know, now the email is our main communication, right? No one is using fax like before or letters. You need to send someone important information. You send by email. Business are running through email. I mean, mail is very important right now. Now, the private email, like your company email, they have their own tracking system. I mean, in Microsoft Outlook, there is an option that allow you to trace email. If you send someone an email, you can trace, and you can know if the receiver receives the email and open it, you get a notification. But what about the free email? If you have an Hotmail or Gmail or Yahoo, can you trace the email? If I'm sending you an email on your Gmail account, can I know once you open this email? In Gmail itself and Hotmail and Yahoo, they don't have this feature for tracing email, but you can use some third-party website, like the site I open right now, confirm.to. Or there is another website which is readnotify.com or didtheyreadityet.com. I mean, just search for email tracing website. Some of them are free, some of them are paid. But the point is, you go and you create an account here. And after that, any email you send from your free email like Gmail or Hotmail, assume that you will send me an email. And assume my email is Atif, for instance, at hotmail.com, and you want to send me an email with the tracing. So what you're going to do, you open your Gmail, you write my email address, and then you have to register on this website first. You should have an account here, and then for anyone that you are sending an email, you can add at the end of his email address dot confirm .2. Okay, so any mail address that you are sending, you have to add at the end of this part .confirm.2. So what happened is, once I receive this email, I will not see this part. I mean, I will not be aware that this mail is traced and whoever sent it are tracking the email. But once he open the email, I will receive an email saying that email has been opened, has been received and opened. And to give you a confirmation, he will also give you the IP of my computer. It's public IP. So if I'm telling you that I didn't receive the email, you can tell me, no, you received the email, you opened this date and this time and from this IP and from this country. So whoever did this website and similar website, it was not for exposing people IP. But what happened is, people are using that to get the IP of their victim. So I'm sitting there, I'm sending you an email just by opening the email, no attachment, no link, just by opening the email, I will receive your IP. And this is the public IP, which is the router IP. And it's quite easy to compromise the router, as you're gonna see during this training. So what I'm saying is, it's just a small example showing you it's not actually so technical to gather information about people. And very, very deep information, as you're going to see later on. And I just need to use some website and some tools, and I'll be able to get a huge amount of critical information that I can use to compromise the system. So this is just a small proof of concept. By the way, any tools or anything that I'm explaining related to email, do not use it on your own personal email. For any testing, create an email for this course and test whatever you are doing. Sending an email, cracking an email. So do not use your personal email for any of those tools or any hacking technique. Use a test mail. Once you are comfortable with whatever you practice, then feel free to use whatever you want.